Hello everyone and welcome back to SimCity and welcome back to Urban Design Lodge Community Project. We have a couple of other YouTubers around here. We have SimCity Brian. Say hello.
Hello.
Strict Toaster.
Hello.
Sat.
Hello.
Yuto.
Hello.
Flux.
Hello.
And have I forgot someone?
Conrad.
Conrad. Joe Love's here too, right? Oh no, he left. He left. Joe Love left already.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, Joe left a long time ago.
Oh. He left like two episodes ago.
He left 2 episodes ago.
Two whole episodes ago. It's been like days, guys. What are we doing? Anyway. Awesome. We are back finally.
Get not back really to finally. Building
it's been like 5 minutes.
I'll call your city, Aruga. Is going well.
Plateau City.
Aruga, tell me how's your oil importation going?
Slow.
Slow? Okay, but it's happening.
It's happening. I also...
Whoa.
There are also a couple of oil... on their way to our construction site over there. Of our
yeah, I can see you already sent 8,000, so that's great.
Yeah, I try to keep it up.
Yeah, I'm almost there to start my first shipment of metal and alloy. So that would be good. Also, did you do recycling center by any chance?
I think. I can add, yeah, a single recycling center or so. I have enough cash flow.
Okay.
Should be possible.
Okay, because now I'm in the green, because I was in the red a couple of minutes ago, because most of the buildings in my city were upgrading. But I think I can do recycling now. But if you can do it and it's easier on your part, better, because that will like mess up with my economy a little bit. So.
Man, I got like the most unfortunate placement of ore ever because I'm trying to find a place to put my refineries now or my whatever you call these things, smelting factories. And I have like no room in my city anymore. I don't even know what to do.
I like what you did, Aruga. Oh, sorry.
No, it's okay. I was just going to say, I think our great work is getting closer to being done now. We just need the
dang, that's
oil.
Fast. Holy crap.
Well, not really. It's more that we just don't have anything coming from fuel yet, which we still need. Almost everything's coming from Brian right now.
And the traffic is backed up very bad going into the great work. So it's taken a long time.
Is it? Oh, I can't really
see
it.
Yeah, me too. There's a huge line on our outside of our airport for some reason.
But yeah, Aruga, I like your road system. It's so cool.
Thanks a lot. It was a lot of work.
Yeah, the ramps and the center where you raise the circle.
Ooh, I want to look.
It gives it like some 3D characteristics of it. It just pokes out.
3D is in city? That's crazy.
Yeah, terraforming.
When you zoom out, it kind of looks like a speaker or Mickey Mouse kind of.
Yeah. Disneyland.
Ooh, yeah, put up some theme parks.
Ooh, that'd be fun.
Yeah.
Those are a lot of fun to build.
If you want to, or if you have it.
That's pretty crazy.
Can I ask you something? Now. Is it cheaper to get a large fire station with a hazmat team, or just let the thing burn and rebuild it, like bulldoze and have it grow again? When you get a hazmat fire,
hazmat I think is expensive to maintain.
It is, but I don't think it's a good idea to let them burn and just destroy them and rebuild them.
yeah, because hazmats explode and they affect other surrounding buildings.
Plus, I think it'll scare you when they blow up.
I actually don't know if it actually does anything that bad though. Besides just, I mean, the blowing up thing, but I don't know. I don't know if that's like severe enough to
scary factor.
I mean, I built the hazmat, but the fire stations in general and the in the hospitals are so ridiculously expensive. I don't know if it's worth it or not.
Yeah. And only if effective if you don't have traffic, I guess, for your trucks to get there.
Ah, that bug didn't fix. I still have that swamp. That's too bad.
Yeah, I saw on Reddit, too, where the guy had the same issue on your same plot.
Oh, like, of course.
Yeah.
I really hope that it gets fixed sometime because I don't like having a swamp.
Are you boys having any issues with your residence? Say, for instance, I've got a tower here and it's got a little description called "We're sick, we need a doctor," when I've got a fully upgraded hospital.
I have not seen that before.
I'm getting that quite often. And also, "We're sick, we need a doctor," and what's the other one? There's no shopping around here, and I've got plenty of shops around everywhere.
That. Yeah, that happened to me just a minute ago. I had someone right next to
me. So frustrating.
Yeah, like right next to a commercial spot, and he's like, "I can't find where to shop," and he leaves.
Exactly, exactly.
So when the ecology is done, would you and me, Conrad, have to convert to commercial and industry?
Is that what we have to do? Not necessarily convert, but I've never had any issues with the arcology where we had to convert. And one thing that I have realized is that your tourism is boosted quite fundamentally, and also all your commercial buildings get a lot more profit because you get a lot more visitors going through your city.
So tourism-wise, is better than an airport?
From what I've played around with, yes. If there is one of the great works which is most advantageous, it's the arcology. It gives you the most benefit out of all of them from my personal game playthrough since the game has come out and I've tested and played around with all the great works. Yeah, the arcology is definitely by far the best to have.
I agree, too. Space Center would be second. You know, it boosts the tech level without actually having to have colleges and universities if you're into that.
In your whole quad, you wouldn't need those universities anymore. You just have the Space Center.
That's correct.
Oh, that's cool.
I'm getting issues with not having enough high wealth shoppers, even though I have tons of high wealth everywhere.
Yeah, see, there's little things like that which constantly frustrate me because these people are constantly not happy because of something when they have it right there for them, and then the place goes abandoned. Ugh, just non-stop, just constantly fixing. All right, demolish this building, regrow again. Everything's fine. Oh, we can't find any shops. Oh, boom, gone. And the process just keeps going in this vicious circle.
Oh, I just realized this whole time I haven't had any more than 2 garbage trucks, so I've had like no garbage collection and everyone's all mad. But I wasn't seeing the icon at all. It wasn't red or anything. That's too bad. Work on that now.
It's nice when your city is running well and you don't get a lot of those abandonments.
Yeah.
It doesn't always happen.
So you're still at the 95% approval rating, Brian? Because you unlocked like the whole mansion, I think.
Yeah, I'm at 94% right now.
Wow, nice.
I'm at 75.
I'm still at the 75s. Yeah.
Oh god.
My high wealth buildings have no shoppers. I'm lazy to fix it right now. I'm just waiting on the arcology.
When the arcology builds, I want to definitely see how your city handles the traffic going through that.
How it produces a lot of traffic? I've never seen an arcology in action before.
The arcology, once it's completed, I think it has close to, I can't remember, Brian, how much, over 1 million people? Or close to 2?
Dang.
I think it's close to 2.
Yeah, close to 2 million. So be prepared.
Well, good thing I'm here then with this. Or, yeah.
I just now realized that the School of Medicine not only lets you obviously unlock the medical stuff, but you can also, it like reduces the chance of people getting sick. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I thought it was just unlocked stuff. That's cool.
Yuto, you don't have a university in your region, do you, by any chance?
No, I removed it.
Okay, excellent.
Like, I have the School of Law, which helps with crime, and I have School of Science that actually helps boost tech levels, which with the Space Center, I won't need that anymore.
Right. Yeah, I just added all those on now. Those are helping out.
My helicopters are not working for some reason. I think... Well, you guys were able to build the airport, Aruga and Strict, so I don't know. Because Brian just told me, like, you need the airport, like, on or in the region for the helicopters to work.
We're not even close to being finished with the airport. I mean, the construction started, but it's going to take several hours of gameplay.
Yeah, I know. But just, like,
you mean helicopters, like, at police station
the
and
fire
all
helicopters?
That? Yeah. All you need is, like, a small inside your city airport, that's all.
Oh, and mice? In the city or not in the region?
Oh, any city. As long as there's one person with a city that has, like, an airport, then the actual air support features on, like, the police station and fire services become unlocked.
Well, Tamahan has one right here, but I don't know if it's on or not. I'm going to visit it.
It should be on from what I've last seen.
I hope so. Because I have some buildings burning down and the helicopters are not doing anything.
Yeah, I quite often get my police station where the helicopter goes up, but then already the crime has been taken care of and it goes just back down.
Yeah, that's why I don't use the police helicopters, because the cop cars respond faster.
Oh, so Strict, I noticed a weird glitch the other day with the police station. The police station itself raises land value, but the jails attached to it lower it, but they still show up green on the wealth map, or the land value map.
That's true. That's interesting.
Really interesting if they would do that, though.
Well, they probably mixed up a little bit. I mean, I guess they probably have the highlights attached to just the building itself, not the different modules. So the jails would be adopting the positive land value attribute, but they separately have the lower land value attribute. Where's my
okay? So yeah, Tamahan's airport is closed because it doesn't have water. Oh, his road is not connected. What's that? What did he do to his city? It's like all gone. Or it's just not connected somehow. I don't know what's happening.
Who is this that's missing a city or?
Tamahan. Like, he had half his city all developed, and then he just destroyed half of it. I don't know what happened.
Is he buying electricity from you? Because he's got no electricity.
Yeah, he's buying it from me.
Okay.
That's why I have so much excess.
I have a big, big problem. The airport is generating this massive gridlock, and now it's reaching my city, so it's basically all collapsed. No cars can get in or out of my city. It's like I don't have an entrance anymore.
It's like the airport or Great Works haven't adopted the Update 7 traffic thing yet.
Yeah. But also, I don't get why all these cars are going to the airport. Like, it's closed, people.
They just want to go look.
Yeah, no.
Construction workers.
Yeah, but the construction begins after.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Government red tape.
So far, I was only able to send 90 tons of alloy of the 1,500 and only 60 tons of metal. And I don't know if that's a bit of Aruga's work, too.
Yeah, I sent a bit metal over to the Great Work.
TVs have officially passed halfway.
Nice. Yeah, 36K.
Yep.
I'm slow on the alloy.
I'm pushing
the alloy as well.
My alloy is like all full. It's just the traffic jam that's causing the slow trade. And plus, I'm looking at everybody's cities, so it's probably not updating as fast.
Huh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm going to look at Zat's new design for the highway.
If you visit another city, you're exporting or transferring to the Great Work pauses.
Yes, that'd be nice if it would stay, if you're like, as long as you're in the region, but I don't think it does. Same with city, like your city pauses altogether.
I guess I should stop looking at people's cities.
Yeah, well,
I'm
like
looking at stats right now.
Yeah, it's working a little bit better. It still gets packed during rush hour, but it clears up after rush hour.
I'll see what you've done. That's sick. Yeah, that will work really well.
Hmm? Oh, you're in it too?
Yeah. Everyone exiting now has to take a right turn. Oh, no. Yeah, left turn and a right turn to get into the city. There you go.
Yeah, unfortunately, people leaving have to take a left, which crowds it a bit, but not as much as the people coming in.
So, if I'm trying to export my alloy to the Space Center, would I set it to use locally or export?
Use locally.
Use locally.
Use locally. Okay, that's what I thought. Just want to make sure. I haven't done a whole lot of great works. I usually end up building my cities too fast, and then it does not
sure.
work enough.
Are you guys sure about that? Because I'm exporting it, and it's as long as I have someone, like some enterprise consuming the resource in my city, then it will send it there. But after, let's say, the smelting factory storage is full, it will start exporting it, and I will be making money.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I did that in a previous city, and it was working the same way.
It's probably
that's what I'm doing right now. It seems to be working.
Forgot what you said.
So you're saying that you're exporting it and it's sending it to the Great Work and making you money?
No. So I have the option to export it, but first it's sending it to the smelting factory or whatever I need to, fulfill inside of my city, and then whatever's left, if you have your trade depot has metal or whatever raw ore in your storage, then we'll export that unless you need it inside. So let me give you a easier example. If you have a coal power plant in your city, it will send coal first to your power plant, and then it will export whatever's left.
Okay, coal first and then export with stuff. Okay, I see what you mean. That makes sense.
The highway interchange is a bit of a silly thing that they've done. How they've only made it from a 3-lane exit into a 2-lane exit. I think the ramp which crosses over the highway, which turns left, I think that should remain as a 2-laner.
Mm-hmm.
And then have the one.
Wait, are you talking about those right? T-junctions into Zat City or something like that?
Yes.
Yeah, exactly. Essentially anyone leaving or entering the city has one lane to go through.
And it's bold. That interchange right there, it's the actual highway interchange, which is bottlenecking his city.
Mm-hmm.
I also think it is kind of ridiculous how they have a 3-lane highway going into your city, even if it's like straight going in, like it is for me, not like a T junction, because it just makes like a random intersection. It makes a merge down from 3 to 3 again, but it's like it. I don't know. It's hard to describe, but the highway is like a larger size.
Those intersections don't really do too much to the traffic, but sometimes there's people doing U-turns and things there.
Yeah, it creates a U-turn point for the
I thought it was 4 originally. I guess it's only 3-lane, but still it's just kind of weird how they make it a different type of road, and it makes it a weird looking intersection.
You can draw highways in your city. just ask Prox.
Yeah,
if only he was here.
I thought about that.
Okay, what's now I'm blocking both lanes of my highway.
Oh. So what are you doing?
Yeah, so the lane that goes through the airport is totally gridlock, and now the lane coming back from the airport is also gridlocked because no one can get into my city.
Hmm. Oh, you got rid of the circle roundabout.
Yeah, because it was just a mess.
I'ma look.
But it's pretty bad.
Are you gonna change your city name back to like strict something?
Maybe. I haven't thought of that. I've been busy doing other things, but yeah, maybe. Why not? I don't know what I should call it.
A strict overlook.
a strict overlook. Actually, how are we doing population-wise? 1,081,000.
Wow. Region.
That's nice. Are you guys getting the same number?
Yeah, I've seen 82,000.
1,066,000.
1,078,000, so it's all close.
Yeah, yeah, about that.
Yeah.
So I win.
I have 82,000, just saying.
Good. Okay. You won.
So strict, what you can do is do the same thing what Zat did, is have that avenue go over the main highway or main avenue and then reconnect onto the right side.
Oh, wait, what do you mean exactly?
You can look at mine for an example.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go your seated real quick. We're getting close to our time, guys, though.
So. Yeah, we're about 20 minutes in now.
I'm gonna pay a real quick visit to Satan with 3 T's for the reasons he explained in the previous episode.
Say it with a French accent.
Satan.
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 Ho 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 ho.
Do they speak French in British Columbia?
Not really. I mean, it is still official language over here, but it's on all the food packaging.
So basically, what are you saying, Yuto? Just have a long stretch of avenue without intersections?
No. If you look at my city entrance, my main road is going over the other main road.
And it curves back.
Yeah, so everyone coming into the city takes a right turn instead of taking a left, which makes
less
of a backup for going in, but it's causing a bit of a backup going out because
it's okay. I'll give it a try, but yeah, this looks good. I don't know if I have enough room for that, but
it does clear up my streetcars though, since they take a different route completely.
Okay, I want to play with that real quick.
I'm really tempted.
Or maybe in the next episode. I don't know. What do you guys think?
Huh? What?
Yeah, we're probably getting pretty close.
Yeah, let's wrap it up.
Okay.
Aruga?
Okay.
Okay.
Give us an outro.
Thanks for watching.
Bye, everybody.
Okay, subscribe.
Yes, subscribe and like and whatever.
Check out everyone else's channels.
All right.
Bye.